This is Big Zion Mission at Baptist Church, 521 West 65th Street, 773-488-4688. Where Pastor Antonio M. Grafton Jr. is our leader. Look, we're in family and friendship day. Don't trust that dial. CAN TV, Channel 36 on RCN, WOW, Comcast, and Channel 99 on AT&T. Don't touch that dial. Enjoy the program already in progress. In Jesus' name, this is Reverend Sean David Coleman. Amen.
Thank you.
roll has to come. Somebody gonna have to get top out. Somebody get top on the roll. Because he might even an outfit before he leaves.
My brothers and sisters, Jesus said, we are free. We are His free. My brothers and sisters, I've been around for some time, not long as some folk, but I know what a true friend is. If I can use some of my street terminology, is that when I was a young man in the streets, there were five of us. And where the five of us went, we stayed together.
Yeah.
And when we used to drink, somebody called up a drink, I know that dog will drink, I know that. You've been saved now, so you don't drink, but when you used to drink. Yeah, you did. I know some of us that I ain't do that. You don't have to play it off with me. I understand. Some of you were too good at shooting. I understand that. But when I grew up, we used to drink while I was grown. Oh, yeah.
Amen.
sharing that feel of love for one another. Let me say this to us. Our faith and religion is based on Jesus Christ going to Calvary. And if we cannot abide in the love that is said in the scripture, we got a problem. We can't get along with one another. You don't like the way I dress. You don't like how I sing. And if I step on your feet, you're about ready to curse me out in the choir stand. Something wrong with our faith in God. We've always figured that sometimes folks be singing off key. Some folks say, I don't want to sing next to Sister Joan because she throws me off. What you need to do sometimes is hold your ear and keep singing. And every now and then, that's what you need to do. You encourage her to keep singing. We've lost our love for one another. We'd rather talk about one another. Sometimes we just can't wait to get on. Yeah, come on now. Girl, you see Sister Joan. Girl, I got to hear from you. Those that ain't here to come to church Sunday morning, first thing they say, girl, I got to hear from you, because I know you know the story. And my story do you know? First of all, you all have been saying, we need to help Sister Joan. We need to do right by Sister Joan. That's what we do. Making us feel like we done something. And what makes it so bad, we've been singing, I love the Lord, I love the Lord. Then you get home and call up your friend and say, did you see Sister Jones in that tight dress? Come on! That love does not do that. No. The Bible says love is not puffed up. No. Love is not envious. Love is not jealous. For God is love. And we ought to love one another. Yes. What do you mean, Bill? Well, listen. Sometimes you may not be able to have this grimy job. When we go somewhere out of town, Randy and I and Mother Tony, and when we don't have, we share what we got. You don't hear what I say. We share with what we got. And I'm always willing to share what I got. In our childhood coming up, I come from a mother who didn't have a high school education. But she had God in her heart and in her life. She taught me how to share. We come from a kitchenette apartment, baby. And in that kitchenette apartment, we had to learn how to share. We had to learn how to share the bathroom, share the kitchen. And when somebody didn't have enough food, Mrs. Dawson always said, Abel, bring the boys over here. I got something in this room. We shared. That was true love. We done lost that. Everybody, I got my own. We ain't got time to share. Friends, now, ain't no more such thing as friends. You might as well call me in. Because we don't love like God tells us to love. We lost true love. My mom used to tell me, my friend that I grew up with, tell me, if you see your mama fall in the street, you need to go pick her up. She said, because that's your mother. Because she sacrificed her life for you. No matter what she is, you know, here today now, no matter what she is, that's still your mama. You hear me today. I'm so grateful to God that my mama may not have had a high school education, but she told me how to share. When we used to have popsicles on the stick, we used to break them in half and share one. And I'm going to get some news for you. If we got one around here, kiss up to God and lick it in the head for the other folks. Y'all don't know nothing about that. That's what the other folks talking about true love. That's what they projected to us when we were growing up. You had to share what I give you. My mom used to love to make cupcakes for the whole block. And the first thing the folks used to say, Miss Bell, where's those cupcakes that she said, I got them baking now. She taught me the meaning of sharing my life with somebody else. We're too stingy with one another. We don't have the time to share our life with one another. We have the old cliche, I got mine, you get yours. Yeah. What a foolish thing to say if we're supposed to be Christian. Yeah. Jesus Christ went to Calvary, fried. Died. Oh, he died. Yeah. He died
But
He first loved me before I loved him. I'm glad about it. I'm glad that God took care of me. I'm glad that one day around prayer meeting time, God of love snatched me from that old way. I'm happy. There's nothing like being a child of
God. Amen.
Amen. The man in them walk through their walk. We're walking up the King. When I'm at the house of prayer, when Tyrone be praying that, we're walking up the King's highway. I get the sweat, because I know
everything to God. God is present.
Good spirit present. I bring before you Deacon George Thomas. This church, we welcome you to praise the Lord with us. God bless you. God keep you.
Thank you, Minister Hart. Now, can we have a response from a visitor? Our friends.
Amen.
Thank you.
can't laugh at the church after we're gone.
Amen.
We can go. And when we used to drink, some of y'all don't drink, I know that y'all don't drink, I know that.
been saved now since you don't drink, but when you used to drink. Yeah, you did. I know some of us that I ain't do that. You don't have to play it off with me. I understand. Some of you were too good at you. I understand that. But when I grew up, we used to drink while I was growing. Oh yeah. I didn't know.
Something wrong with our faith in God.
We've always figured that sometimes folks be singing off key. Some folks say, I don't want to sing next to Sister Joan because she throws me off. What you need to do sometimes is hold your ear and keep singing. And every now and then, that's what you need to do. You encourage her to keep singing.
Yeah.
We've lost our love for one another.
Yeah.
We'd rather talk about one another. Sometimes we just can't wait to get on.
Yeah,
yeah, come on now. Girl, you see Sister Joan. Girl, I got to hear from you. Those that ain't here to come to church Sunday morning, first thing they say, girl, I got to hear from you, because I know you know the story. And what story do you know? First of all, you ought to have been saying, we need to help Sister Joan. We need to do right by Sister Joan. That's what we do. Making us feel like we done something. And what makes it so bad, it's the distance. We've been singing, I love the Lord, I love the Lord. Then you get home and call up your friend and say, did you see Sister Jones in that tight dress? Come on! That's love, love, love does not do that.
No.
The Bible says love is not puffed up.
No.
Love is not envious. Love is not jealous. For God is love. We ought to love one another.
Yeah.
What do you mean, Bill? Well, listen. Sometimes you may not be able to have this prime example. When we go somewhere out of town, Randy and I and Mother Tony, and what we don't have, we share what we got. You don't hear what I say. We share with what we got. And I'm always willing to share what I got. In our childhood coming up, I come from a mother who didn't have a high school education. But she had God in her heart and in her life. She taught me how to share. We come from a kitchenette apartment, baby. And in that kitchenette apartment, we had to learn how to share. We had to learn how to share the bathroom, share the kitchen. And when somebody didn't have enough food, Mrs. Dawson always said, Abel, bring the boys over here. I got something in this room. We shared. That was true love. We done lost that. Everybody, I got my own. We ain't got time to share. Friends, now, ain't no more such thing as friends. You might as well call me in. Because we don't love like God tells us to love. We've lost true love.
Yeah.
My mom used to tell me, my friend that I grew up with, tell me, if you see your mama fall in the street, you need to go pick her up. She said, because that's your mother. Because she sacrificed her life for you. No matter what she is, and I'm here today now, no matter what she is, that's still your mama. And you're here today. I'm so grateful to God that my mama may not have a high school education, but she told me how to share. When we used to have popsicles on the stick, we used to break them in half and share one. And I'm going to get some news for you. If we got one on the ground, we'd kiss up to God and lick his head for the other folks. God don't know nothing about that. That's what the old folks talk about. You talk about true love. That's what they projected to us when we were growing up. You had to share what I give you. My mom used to love to make cupcakes for the whole block. And the first thing the folks used to say, Miss Bell, where's those cupcakes that she said, I got them baking now. She taught me the meaning of sharing my life with somebody else. We're too stingy with one another. We don't have the time to share our life with one another. We have the old cliche, I got mine, you get yours. What a foolish thing to say if we're supposed to be Christian. Jesus Christ went to Calvary, fried. Died. Oh, he died.
Yeah.
He died, fried.
Yeah.
Stayed in the grave 3 days. But early, Sunday morning. Sunday morning. That God, who said, if you abide in me, let my words abide in you. You can ask the Father what you want. Early, Sunday morning. Early, Sunday morning. All power in heaven and earth is in the change his flat tire. And I'm gonna tell you how the Holy Spirit works with him. He was struggling. I just came down from the 29th floor in the government building, and I started walking. I walked right past him. But I'm gonna tell you about that Holy Spirit. When I walked right past the Holy Spirit, I know you ain't gonna walk past that man. He's in distress. He's got a crush. How dare you, if you say you're a child of the King, I had to back up. I'm here, I hear what I'm telling you. I had to back up and say, let me help you. He said, I got an arm. I said, no, you can't get it. You got a crush. And how you gonna get down and change the tire with your rug and all that? Let me do that. Let me tell you something. I'm gonna tell you something. I thought I was sharp that day. I had my best slacks that day. Yeah, I had my best slacks. I was going to work. But God said, sometimes you gotta give up the best. You hear what I'm saying? I thought I was cute. Sometimes we gotta get ugly for the Lord sometimes. Yeah. Y'all ever got ugly and shouting for God? Yeah. When your hair starts going this way and that way, you get mad. You can't look it good. But after a while, you can't look attractive. Why? You can say, I've been shouting for the Lord. Right? Stand back and get on my knees and change man's tire. After I changed the tire, he looked at me and said, what can I give you? I said, I've already got my blessing. We don't really mean to. That's why it means so much to us when you say that you're a Christian. Because a Christian walks upright, talks upright, do what God requires. That's why I say you ain't my friend no more. You're my friend, you're not a servant anymore. Yeah. You know what I want, what I expect of you. Love abide in your heart. Yeah. Just like love abide in my Father's love, so does it in me. It's got to abide in you. We're too sophisticated. I'm going to tell you like it is. We're too sophisticated. We come to church all bushy, man. We don't want to sweat anymore because that might mess up my dude. We don't want to sweat because I took my shower and my bath and I don't want to get funky. Because somebody's sitting next to me. But sometimes you gotta get sweaty sometimes. You gotta get funky sometimes when you're talking for the Lord. You gotta, come on now. You got to really get down and do what you know is right. Amen. You can't just sit there and you know God has done something for you. You got to shout, amen. You got to kick your shoes off. I want you to get holes in your socks, but kick it off anyhow. That's all right. Every now and then, you got to get ugly for God. You can't get stingy and get sophisticated. Oh, we don't say that anymore. We don't get happy anymore. You can't say amen to lie. I spoke today about the man that was at the beautiful gate.
Yeah.
When God healed, you hear what I said? When God healed him, the Bible said he can't leave and jump in the church. Even he had rags on, but he was jumping. What was he proclaiming? God loved. God healed me. I'm happy. I once, look, I was crippled, but now I can walk. I can talk. I can now participate in the service of the Lord. I'm going to shout for the God of love. For God is love. Why? He first loved me before I loved him. I'm glad about it. I'm glad that God took care of me. I'm glad that one day around prayer meeting time, God of love snatched me from that old way. There's nothing like being a child of the King. Amen. The man in them walk through their walk. We're walking up the King. When I'm at the house of prayer, when Tyrone be praying that, we're walking up the King's highway. I get the sweat, but I know I'm walking. I'm walking.